I have fond memories of the 1970s. CB radios, bell bottoms, disco. But as an economist, there's one 1970s trend I just don't miss. Out of control inflation followed by high unemployment. Inflation and unemployment were once bound at the hip as the U.S. economy moved through repeatable stages of the business cycle. The economy would expand and eventually grow fast enough to encourage rising inflation. The Federal Reserve would raise interest rates to contain the inflation pressure. This was associated with a recession, rising unemployment, and finally, lower inflation. Then the 90s happened. In the mid-1990s and continuing into the 2020s, inflation pressures became muted and were barely impacted by changes in economic activity, unemployment, monetary policy, or stock market trends. The post-World War II inverse relationship between unemployment and inflation has been broken. We are now entering the era of modern monetary theory, or MMT. That is, the policy response to the pandemic has brought a fusion of fiscal and monetary policy. Massive government spending, financed by debt, bought in large part by central banks. Here's the real story, according to an economist. Now, hopefully, a vaccine will bring a strong economic rebound, but will it also bring inflation? Some economists believe the new MMT environment, driven by expansionary fiscal policy and financed by monetary policy, may encourage inflation to make a comeback. Only time will tell if the inflation-unemployment relationship will be revived in this new era, with the pendulum swinging away from monetary policy and toward fiscal policy.